All right, cool. Next thing I want to talk about is Young Miami, aka Diddy's ex-lover. Ding, ding, ding. So she has just dropped her latest episode of her show, Carisha Please. And whoa, she's spilling the tea. Well, I mean, man, she's not spilling any tea. I'm like, she didn't say shit, bro. This thing was so heavily edited, you could even see. It was crazy. But yeah, it was interesting. They did have some chats. So she's got her bestie, Casper Nyovest. Oh, sorry, I meant Saucy Santana. Yeah, so she's got her bestie, Saucy Santana, as, you know, I guess the host or the I don't know what do. Yeah, the host, you know, just the person who's asking her questions. And oh my geez, oh my days. So yeah, so she asks, he asks her about Diddy, and this is her response.
I feel like the people that I thought that would be in my corner, mm-hmm. or that are like, what's going through the shit? Nobody called me. Shit, nobody called me to see how I was doing. Like, people was really like, you thought.
Yeah. So when it comes to Diddy, why do you think that you are so heavily involved in everything? Like, everything that comes out about him, like you said, it's automatically, well, what you think, why you, how you feel, what you got to say?
Because people feel like I was, and I made him my brand, and I feel like he's on brand for me. I got a Diddy environment to my life. I was still doing Roulette in the Split all right on. Slap on my head. I never think I was making the program. I was still on my City Girls shit. I was still doing remixes. Don't play with it.
With Gucci Mane.
Gucci Mane. I was still working. City Girls was on tour with Jack Harlow. We had At Bad. So Diddy came to me with the song. Told JT let's get on this record. Like, I was still doing City Girls shit. I was heavily involved in the group. I never thought I was making the program.
So with Diddy, what was your experience with dating him? Because I feel like in the headlines, it's a lot of just chaos, and it's a lot of allegations. And so I think that's what makes people feel like, well, since you were so heavily involved, you were part of these things, or you're around these things. So what was your experience like, you know, dating?
Well, I met Diddy at P Party, and I met him when he was in Love Era, and I met Diddy when the world was celebrating him and giving him his flowers while he was alive. Mm-hmm. Like, he did, he was getting the Global Icon Award, the Lifetime Achievement Award, the Key to the City. He had a new album that was coming out, so I was celebrating him with the world. And I just feel like everybody trying to crucify me for it. Like, you was his biggest advocate, you was his chili, but I was just celebrating when the world was celebrating him. Mm-hmm. So why am I being crucified, or why am I being separated?
Yeah.
When I was like, the frequency is how he's alive. So that's like, it's always, what's up, queen?
Yes.
So I just
feel
like,
yeah, I get what like, she means, though, because like, when they started dating, you know what I mean? Like, that's when, because you guys must remember, like, this whole Diddy thing is just, it was like a night switch. You know what I mean? Like, it just happened like fucking overnight. You know what I mean? The lawsuit came, the next day he paid. That's pretty much when the whole thing is like, from that two instance, the whole shit, that's when it started. That's when people just like, everything just flipped on Diddy. You know what I mean? So it's just like, you can just imagine, like, one day you're dating this guy, you know, next day it's just like, you know, files and files and files and receipts are just coming out about this guy. You're just like, what the fuck? It was like, I don't even know if you knew. Because just like, we don't know if she was involved in these things, if she was part of these things, you know, because, hey, but who knows, man. Carisha, please.
Oh, new Aaron, that wasn't my experience. Mm-hmm. Like, when I met him, it was just like, I told y'all on season one, I asked him, like, why you fuck with me? Why you fuck with the city girl?
Yeah.
Why you coming into my room? Because I'm on some whole other shit. Like, you know my lyrics and stuff. Yeah. And it's just like, when I got with him, he was just a man. And like, it was more of like, okay, we ain't gonna do that. We gonna sit, we gonna communicate, we gonna get the solutions. What's going on? Like, we ain't even going that route. So that was my experience with him.
So a lot of the things that people really like say about him, you didn't experience that as in dating. That's not something that you saw. So is that the reason why you never said anything? Is that the reason why, when all of these allegations and lawsuits came apart, like, why didn't you speak?
Add time in the age of light. Skip that odd.
Speak on something that wasn't my experience. And I can't speak on something that I don't know. I can't speak on these allegations because I wasn't around in time. I don't know that person, and that wasn't my experience.
So with you being, I feel like, a survivor of domestic violence, he never hit you in a relationship. He was never violent. It was that something that you had to tolerate, or that wasn't a...
Good question. Good question, Casper.
That wasn't a part of, you know, because I feel like that's the biggest thing to him right now is, you know, what he's going through in these lawsuits and, you know, that video that came out. And it's like, I feel like a lot of people are wondering, was that your experience? And I know personally that you've been through domestic violence before, and I don't think that's something that, I know that's something that you've grown from and that you don't tolerate.
I've been through romantic violence in two relationships. And I told myself, I think the second relationship, I would never put myself in this situation again, especially now being a mom.
Did he hit you? Answer the question. Answer the asked. Yeah, you're talking about the left, right, and center. Did he dunder you also, you know? Did he put you in them freak offs? You know, did he make you do funny things with other people? Like, you know, like Cassie alleged and proved pretty much, you know what I mean? Like, what's the talk? What's the chat? You know, like, we understand you want to talk about your side, but it's like, it's time to expose the nigga as well.
My mom, I was a mother then, but I have my daughter. Like, I would never put myself in that position. I don't stand for domestic violence. I'm just not going for that.
So do you feel like, wait, dating, did he, like, was it a business relationship?
She didn't answer the question. She didn't answer, did he hit you? Yes or no?
You feel like it was beneficial for you?
I feel like it was beneficial for both of us. Mm-hmm. I think that, like, you know, I was able to come in, be a brand ambassador for Deleon and take it to a whole other level. Because I feel like, I won't say nobody wasn't drinking Deleon, but...
Nobody wasn't drinking Deleon.
But when I came, it was just like, it's a city where someone we drinking Deleon, we acting bad. So I feel like I was an asset. I honestly just feel like with Diddy, like, you know, I met him at a pee party and I don't know what his intentions was, but I don't know if it was like business or he really liked me, but I felt like, you know...
His touches were too chow!
He, when he got me, he really saw something in me. That's why he was like, you know what? You got a big personality. Like, mm-hmm. you should do a podcast. Like, you know how to engage in conversations. Like, you know how to ask good questions. So, yeah. So I felt like, you know, I came into his world and I was able to, like, turn everything he had going on up a notch. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, he had Deleon. I was able to have the whole world drinking Deleon and putting in his songs. Like, I made it popular, you know?
Yeah.
And then with Revolt, I was able to come and make it a number one podcast on Revolt.
Yeah.
So I felt like, you know, and then with him, it was like he was able to, you know, take my career to the next level. I did a Met Gala. I got ready with Vogue. Like, I wasn't going into the relationship thinking, like, I want to get a purse. I want to go on private jets. I want to get diamonds. Like, I feel like I'm up on a mogul. I want to learn something. You know, like, I want to learn business. I want to learn how to, okay, you got a network. How can I get a network? Or, you know, you had a Sean John. How can I make Carisha please the next Sean John? So I went into that relationship, like, on a, like, more of, like, I want to become a mogul and I want to learn about up under. You know, most people just want to get their body done. You want to get a trip. You want to just do that video. I wasn't one of them.
And that's
Carisha, please let him know. Yeah. Fuck with it. Let him know. You see, she went in there. She's trying to get some shit done. You know, she's trying to, you know, she wants the industry secret. She wants the chop. You know, she wants to know how to triple the money. That's good. That's good.
What I respect about you, because even though you a city girl, meeting your best friend and knowing you very womanly. I always say that. And like just a grown woman. And so I even seen the elevation in your production and your team that you started hiring business managers.
Hello.
And
I think that it.
Hello.
I think that like when you get around people, you see certain things. Like you're able to, like, you should be able to learn something from somebody. And I felt like I was able to see, like, how should my business be operating? Like, I should have a cheaper staff.
Yeah.
I should have a business manager.
All right. You're talking a lot. All right. It's interesting. Yeah. So that's pretty much her take on the whole Diddy thing. She doesn't say much. You know, she just says she was with him when he was cool. Then shit got hot. Niggas started asking her questions. The kitchen was too hot, so she had to flee. Pretty much it. But yeah, shout out. I mean, man, this shit was all over the thing. Got like a million views. It was like 20. It's been 20 hours. That was crazy. Yeah, very crazy. Shout out to Carisha, please. And Casper Nyovest. I'm joking. I'm in Saucy Center. Man, Casper's never gonna outlive that joke. In my life, Casper Nyovest is never gonna outlive the joke of looking like Saucy Center. I will always bring it up. I will always bring it up when I'm talking about Casper. I'm sorry, because that is the joke of a century, man. Wow. All right, cool. Let's move on. Bus, I told that baby go. Bus.